where I felt my home was. I have to admit I did not give you my truest reply. You see, nobody ever asked me where is your home. I guess it's quite ironic for someone who's lived in and traveled to so many places. Nobody asked, only assumed. Maybe they thought they knew, maybe no one really cared. But you did, you asked. Now let me answer you from my heart. I have felt this all my life. If there was ever something I knew for sure, this was it. The deep longing, the sadness. A strong desire to be somewhere I couldn't quite consciously grasp or define. There was a knowing in my heart that I was born in the wrong place, under the wrong skies. This is not my soul's true home, I thought. Then came the questions without answers. Why was I dreaming of faraway lands? Why did foreign languages come to me with such ease? Why did I identify so much with different cultures? I had the intense feeling that a part of me was somewhere out there, beckoning me. Something was missing and it was calling out to me. The older I got, the more intense the feeling. Then came the searching, yet not knowing what I was looking for. And the more places I visited, the more obvious it was. Yes, the traveling felt good, but none of the places I visited was home. But I knew it was out there, and the certainty of it kept me going. You see, home can mean different places to different people, but wherever it is, be it a dimension, another universe or the return God, it is that inner space of the heart that gives you an incredible feeling of rightness and warmth within. For those who truly love, home is not a place, it's a feeling. Home is where you are welcome, accepted and loved. It's warm, relaxing and open. It's where our truest selves step out and we can be completely and honestly who we are. It is a place filled with trust, patience and acceptance of each other's weaknesses. Home is where you don't have to pretend or be on your guard. Instead of envy, irritation and exasperation, there is a great understanding, support, forgiveness and compassion. There is no judging, possessing, controlling, boundaries or competition. This is a place where you are loved more than you are needed. One day you will all meet the person who will take you there. You will instantly know that you've known this person for eons, in many lifetimes and beyond. She is your polar opposite, and like magnets you are being pulled together. Yet even in this most powerful energy field, you feel relaxed and totally at ease. Engulfed in the warm security on a familiar ground. In their embrace you know you've come home. Time and place are no longer matter. There is an immediate tie between you which defies verbal description. You recognize yourself in them. Those eyes you had looked upon so many times before in so many faces. So deep you could see their soul and touch the feeling of pure light and love inside. Like mirrors reflecting only your true self back to you. Your mind, heart and consciousness flow together from the same fountain. She is not only a mirror of mind and spirit, but of the soul, the secret longings and aspirations. You love this person like you love yourself, with no expectations or conditions attached to that love, because you are one. You know that life will never be the same and you feel truly blessed. 8BF7XXC B1E9618B8979F8374231B3rd. She is someone who reads you like an open book, who understands you in ways no one else can. She doesn't have that raised eyebrow look that the rest of the world does. It is because she knows you inside out, yet the discovery never stops. You share the same soul blueprint and soul energy, the same essence. The vision, feeling and purpose are the same. You are like the two sides of a coin, one but not the same. Together you create the perfect balance and become more than just the sum of your parts. Each part fitting the other, interlocking like Roman rings, stretching but never snapping apart. When one moves inward the other fills the gap, and when one overflows, there will always be space to send that abundance towards the other. The power of her love is not in what she tells you to do, but in what you are inspired to be. The measure of her love is not in how much you are able to love her, but in the way you are able to love others as a result of it. She understands that you may need to journey deep within to recognize the other within yourself and that there may be some false turns and mistaken identities in the process. Therefore, her love comes with the freedom to explore life with whomever you wish because she knows in the end it will help you find your way back home, to her. This love will not come without its challenges. Being with this person is like cradling your sacred self, but also facing every shadow, every part of yourself, leaving you with nowhere to hide. It has the potential to inspire great inner healing, but only through dealing with a part of yourself that you have chosen not to look at for quite some time, the mirror of you in the other that reflects all that is within you. As your mirror, she will make you experience yourself directly, not through your past experiences, beliefs or ego, but through your heart and soul. She'll make you dig deeper, reach higher, shed light on parts of you that are painful for you to see. She will have no choice but to make you expand and confront yourself. You must be made empty so that light can come in and fill you. Some days you will be so lost that you wish she never existed, and there are days you believe she never really did, except in your imagination. There will be days when you fail, and those days will feel like you are going mad. Other days the mirage transforms itself into the oasis just long enough for you to rest a moment in her arms. Just enough to simply be and feel her as a part of you again. Sometimes we have to travel long and far before we recognize our true home. We may pass it by like a ship in the night. Maybe we are not ready to face it, maybe we are scared. We do not believe it is possible, we doubt it. So we run from it and keep traveling, searching for a place that feels like home, but isn't. While we travel, our soul's flame burns brightly, lighting the way for all parts of the soul that are in separation to return home to the heart of the soul. So if you ask me where my home is, this is my answer. Within weeks of sharing the above with my twin, we shared a beautiful and intense reunion. Years later, he is still the closest thing to home that I have ever known, and I know one day we will return home together. For me, our ultimate homecoming will be the return to our original state of oneness. A return to source, to our eternal life. Seeing the twin flame connection and all its challenges and blessings as simple steps towards this return gives me a sense of peace that I might otherwise have struggled to gain. Please be reassured that even if your twin flame is not physically part of your life, there is comfort to be found in their energetic and spiritual presence. Earth itself begins to feel more like home, just because they are here. You see, the journey home takes us beyond the desire of a physical connection into the fulfillment of a deeper longing than the flesh. That of a shared consciousness. At this level you are already one. You are already in union, even when everything else is up for grabs. Even when your twin flame is not physically present, you can still heal, evolve and continue to live without feeling like you are missing something inside. In fact, the twin is within you for you to connect with. For you to enjoy and love, be it near or far. Settling into this joyous realization is part of coming home. We hope this channel has helped you discover where to start on your actual paths. It's a good karma to put a like, subscribe and share, leave your suggestion in the field below. With all the love to you.